Hello everyone, welcome to lecture on Test Bench for Comparit. At the end of this session, students will be able to build the test bench for comparator and also able to verify the previously designed VHDL module using this test bench, right? Now, before starting with the actual session, let's pause the video and think about what is a comparator circuit. If you remember, in the previous video lectures, we have covered the different VHDL modules for different combinational and sequential devices, that is hardware, full adder, half adder, then comparator, multiplexer, right? So we have already studied that. So this is the comparator. This one is a 2-bit comparator, which is having two inputs, right? A and B, or each one is of 2-bit, right? And it gives you the output, which is a combinedly called Y as a 3-bit signal. It has 3 bits, Y of 0, Y of 1, Y of 2, right? So depending on the inputs conditions, any one of this bit is going to be 1. If A equals to B, in that case, A greater than B in that case, and A less than B in that case, right? So now, before writing the test bench, let's have a look at the VHDL code for this 2-bit comparator, and then we go for the test bench for 2-bit comparator, right? So this is the code for a, okay, so this is the 2-bit comparator, right? And depending on this one, we have the perform the table. So this is the table. So depending on the inputs, A equals to B, in that case Y of 0 bit is 1 and remaining 2 bits are 0. If A is greater than B, in that case Y of 1 bit is 1 and remaining 2 bits are 0. And A less than B, in that case Y of 2 bit is 1 and remaining 2 bits are 0. So these are the, you can say, behavior of your comparator, this one. Now for this behavior, we are going to write the VHDL code. So we know that for every VHDL code, there are three important parts. First is a library declaration, so we have to include the libraries, library IEEE, and in that we are using the package, that is STD Logic 1164. Then second important part is your entity declaration part. In the entity declaration, you are going to write the different inputs and outputs associated with your design. Now in this case comparator, we have already saw that in previous slide, we have two inputs, right, and one output, right? Two inputs, which of everyone is of 2 bits, so that's why it is mentioned as a vector A and B, 1 down to 0, right? 1 down to 0 means it is 2 bits. So there is another way you can write, instead of 1 down to 0, you can write 1 to 2. That is one way. Either you can write 1 down to 0 or 1 to 2. Again, we have output associated with that 2-bit comparator, which is of 3 bits. So that's why again Y is mentioned as a out bit vector type. So again 2 down to 0. So that gives you 2, 1, 0, that is 3 bit, right? Once we done with the entity declaration part, third important part is what? Architecture writing. So again, now this is the architecture for this 2-bit comparator, right? We already saw the syntax of architecture, and in that we have to mention the architecture keyword, then architecture name is there of for which entity you are writing the architecture, that entity name supposed to be here, right? Then your begin keyword you have to use, that's from that begin your actual architecture starts, right? Now here what we have written, if you observe over, this is nothing but the it as per the table whatever we created in a previous slide. This is nothing but the Y of 2, Y of 1 and Y of 0. Now in this case Y of 0 equals to 1, right? So this 001 is assigned, this one is assigning operator in VHDL when you are dealing with the signals, right? So Y of 0 is 1 and remaining 2 signals bits are 0. So this 00 is 1 is assigned with to Y when A equals to B. Else 010 means Y of 1 is 1 and remaining bits are 0. 010 is assigned to Y when A greater than B. Else 100 is assigned to Y when A less than B. Once you done with the architecture writing, you have to end the architecture. So end architecture, right? So architecture is what? It gives the behavior of your system. So this nothing but the behavior of your comparator, right? Now if you done with the code, you can verify the code with the help of simulation. There are different softwares available, tools available in the market to perform, to write the BHDL code and to test that with the help of simulation. One I used over here is the Xilinx to write the code, and I use the inbuilt simulator of that is iSim. And if you perform the simulation on that, you will get the output something like this, right? So these are the signals A and B and output Y, right? And these are the waveforms showing the values. So in this case, A is having 0, 0 value, and after that it is changed and A is having value 0, 1. Here the B is having value 0, 0 in this case, and here it is having value 1, 1. So by comparing the code, whenever A and B are equal, the output is 0, 0, 1. So during this case, your A and B inputs are equal, so it is having value 0, 0, 1. After this, your A is changed to 0, 1, and your B is still 0, 0. So A is greater now in this period. So that's why the output is 0, 1, 0. After this, your B becomes 1, 1, and A is still 0, 1, right? So in this, during this case period, your B is greater than A, so that's why the output is 1, 0, 0. So this is how you can verify the BHDL design code with the help of simulation, right? Now let's go for the test bench writing for the 2-bit comparator, right? Again, in the test bench writing, three important parts are there. One part is a library declaration, another one is a entity part, and third one is the architecture part, same as the VHDL design code, right? So library declaration you have to perform, right? Two lines, library IEEE, and then which package you are using, that package you have to mention, right? Then entity declaration is there, but here you have to write the empty entity. No need to write the ports, no need to write the signals in that one, right? Just write the entity, entity name, entity, entity name, and end entity, that's it, end entity name, that's it. After that, you have to write the architecture, right? So architecture name of, for which entity you are writing, that entity name is. Now here, before writing begin, we have to declare the components. With the help of that component, we are going to test our previously designed code. So component instantiation is supposed to be done. So component instantiation is done for a unit which are we are testing. So we are testing for 2-bit comparator. So whatever the 2-bit comparator entity we are written previously, that entity is taken as a component. So component, same entity name, same port declaration what we did in a previously design code. So A is the input signal of vector type having range 1 down to 0, B is again having a vector type range 1 down to 0, and Y is the output vector type again, but range is 2 down to 0 because 3-bit signal was there. Once you are done with the signals declaration, you have to end the component. So end component, right? Then we have to write the signals which are going to be mapped with these component signals, right? So signal declaration parts are there, inputs are there, input signal A of type vector, right? 1 down to 0, initially value is assigned 0, 0, right? B is again 1 down to 0, right? Output Y, bit vector 2 down to 0, right? Now once we done with the signal declaration part, we have to write the component instantiation for, so that's why one constant is taken, which is having value assigned to is 100 nanosecond, right? Then begin. After begin, your actual architecture starts. So whatever the written between the architecture line and begin keyword, those are the declarative part, right? Now here your actual architecture starts. So here you have to first initiate the unit under test. So component instantiation is done over here. So that syntax is what? first you have to mention the name, right? Component name, comp1 we created in previous slide. Then port map you have to write, keyword port map, and in the bracket you have to map the signals with the component signal. So A is mapped with the A, B is mapped with the B, and Y is mapped with the Y. Once you're done, you're going to write the process now, right? So process is there, process begin, right? Begin keyword you have to use. Now after that, after begin, you're going to write the every test conditions or whatever the inputs variations you are having. Because of the two input signal, you have four possible cases in that, each one A either having value 00 or 01 or 10 or 11. Similarly, B is having 00 or 01. So you have to write that much time. So how to write that? So first value of A is assigned with the 00. Then B is assigned with the value 00. Then we have waited for period. Period is nothing but the value 100 nanoseconds. So we have waited for 100 nanoseconds, right? Then we used assert statement. So actually what assert statement is do? It checks for the Boolean condition. And if the Boolean condition fails, it assert the report statement. So whatever the message you mention in a report statement, that message will be displayed. So there are different types of report statement. It can be note, it can be a warning, it can be error, right? So here we have mentioned as a error, severity error, right? If that condition fails in case, so what is the Boolean condition? This condition here checking. If y equals to 001, when the y of 0th bit is 1, when two inputs are equal, A and B. If that condition true, it will not generate the report statement. It directly go for the next condition, right? So in this case, A is 00, B is 00. So these two signals are equal. So that's why we have mentioned Y of 0 bit 1, right? Again, if A is greater, we mention over here Y of 1 bit is 1. And if B is greater, Y of 2 bit is 1. And remaining bits are 0. So similarly, we have to write the all the cases, right? One more case over here. A is 11, B is 11. Again, both inputs are equal, A equals to B. So Y of 0th bit supposed to be 1. See, we have mentioned over here. And if that condition fails, Boolean expression, in that case we are reporting this statement, right? Once we are done all the condition, now here for example I have mentioned two sample cases. We have to write all the cases, and after that we are done, we have to end the process, right? So end process is there. Then we have to end the architecture. So end architecture. So that is the end architecture. Now this is the code done, test bench done for the 2-bit comparator. Once you done, you can go for the simulation. So this is the simulation output. You can verify with this, when this is the A signal. This one is below that, the signal is B, right? And below that the output signal Y, right? Now here after that individual bitwise is shown output signal, right? Whenever A and B are equal, in that case your output is 001. So 001, all the four cases are shown over here, right? 00 11 10 01, right? Now whenever A is greater, from this you can see Y of 1 bit is 1 filled with the green. Previously Y of 0 bit is 1, remaining bits are 0. So that's why it is shown over here, it is 010. So this is how you can verify the test bench also with the help of simulation. These are the references. Thank you.